All right, Sammy, you may begin. Good luck.
Hey. Good morning. I'm Sammy Garcia, and this is my WLA presentation. Okay. So we're gonna start with my WLA description, which will include my workplace, my mentor, and my role in my workplace. So this is my workplace. It is David Wise & Associates. It is a financial planning firm. It is an independent business. Also, it's located in San Ramon. The building looks like a building on the outside, but on the inside, it's open. And then the building, the offices are around. So, the financial planners here, David Wise & Associates, they all need their business licenses and licenses to sell insurance. And most of them here have business certificates and the licenses in order to work here. The most people they serve here are small business owners and some heads of like households, like parents and stuff like that. And a strength of theirs is that they're experts in their field, so they really know what they're doing. And also, they can help really well. And a weakness, though, is there are about 15 finance planners here. So here are pictures of my workplace. This is the outside, and here's the inside. Here's my mentor. His name is Samson Chan. He is a certified financial planner. He meets with clients and checks their portfolios and just gives them advice on how to handle their finances. And, you know, just answer any questions that they have. So he wanted to be in this field of work when he was in college. He said he wanted to own his own business, and so he went to UC Berkeley and got a bachelor's degree in business. So what he does also is that he, talks with clients and meets them on a personal level and knows them really well. And he holds them accountable for anything that they do with their finances. And so my role, I was the intern here. And so, I guess that would be my official title. And so, why did I do any tasks that Samson had done, such as scanning, filing, completing some workshops, and working on my WLE projects or blogs, and just any other tasks that he wanted me to do. And so, right there it says, do things efficiently and scheduled today. So, what that means is I had to do things on time, and I had to do them well, so I had to be like at a good rate, but also in good quality. And for scheduling, I had to think of what I would do throughout the day, such as at 9 o'clock, I would scan and file some stuff, and then around 10, I would work on my project. And so that's why I did for scheduling my day. So now we'll talk about my WLE project, which includes my project plan and my project action. So my statement of purpose was, the purpose of my project was to help my mentor and his business advertise through an informative video on financial planning. This would help my mentor's business because it would attract new clients. And so the depth would be of average profoundness. So it would hit a lot of people, but I would be like a huge amount. But it'd be good enough because he would draw enough people so he could get new clients. And so it would really affect small business owners and heads of households so that they could hire a financial planner and see how they could finance and handle their finances. The breadth is hopefully 100 people at least can see the video because it will be open to the public viewing. And so it will be on YouTube and my mentor's website. So at least 100 people would be good enough. If there's more, that would be great. And then the longevity, I think it would be about 2 years or more because it is going to be on YouTube and on the internet and my mentor's website. So it would really help that it would stay there for a long time so that many people, as much as they could watch the video, and over 100 people could. So I think those 2 years might be enough, or more could help also. And so I came up with this project because my mentor said he had planned this for a long time, but he never really got around to it. And so I thought, like, I should help him with this because I really wanted him to do this because it really sounded like a good project. And so then, what I had to do was distribute the work equally every Tuesday, so I had to, like, think, like, what to do every Tuesday so that I could finish it on time and that I could also do it well. So, you know, there wouldn't be like any slips or any like mistakes, but I really wanted to do this and I thought like, it would be a really good project. And so this is a schedule of what I would have been, of what I did. It's not really exact because some of the dates had been switched around, but this is like what it would have looked like if I actually did this. But the project really came out well, even though the schedule was a little bit off. And so my project in action, so my project was a video. There was no final result yet because it wasn't finished today. Hopefully it will be finished because me and my mentor planned it for today to be finished. I really put a lot of effort yesterday to finish it. And so Samson and some of my coworkers helped me revise my storyboard. These storyboards, in fact. So this is a prototype of my storyboard, like what I thought would go in it. But then it changed, and so then I did this one where it was a PowerPoint, and then I had to write down different things. And so those two changed over time, and they, my coworkers and Samson, really helped me so that it could be easy to understand that. There you go, you can look at that. So it would be easier to understand, people would actually grasp the ideals of financial planning. So here are some of the pictures of the presentation slash video. And so that's the title, and here's one of the slides. The analogy for it was like a dinner, because it would be easier to understand for people to compare a dinner with financial advice, because it's basically the same process. And here's some notes about how they're the same. And now for the reflection part. So in this part, we'll be talking about the results of my project, the leadership skills, what I learned about myself, profession, and the world of work, what I learned about professionalism and finding a job, and the big picture. So my project's results, so it still wasn't done, so there really isn't any final results. So what I learned is I need to plan ahead of time and evenly, so that means that I have to think of what'll happen if something goes wrong one day, and so I have to make sure something I had to do something on that day so that it could be even amount of work that I would have done on that day. And so like if I didn't do my storyboard, I would at least think of a concept so that next time when I actually do a storyboard that they would coincide, like, kind of, so that it would make sense and the storyboard wouldn't be as confusing. And I also need to try to plan and do tasks in the office better because I don't know, that's what I did at my work, so I tried to plan and I did tasks as best as I could. So, like, I thought what I would do throughout the entire day, like at which times, and I also tried to do many things as much as I could and to the best of my ability so that I could make sure everything was done. And I also, the video helped people get information financial planning and how that could help them, so hopefully that did draw them in. And next is the leadership skills. The leadership skill I used was complete projects effectively, and this is because I had to do many things at a certain rate, but I also had to do them at a really good quality. Like for scanning and filing papers, I had to make sure that they were scanned before I told Samsung, because if they weren't scanned, then the file would be lost because he would have shred them. So I had to make sure that those were done on time and that I made sure they were done. And then the leadership skill that Samson knew was communicate powerfully because he had to talk with many clients and he also had to meet with different people and he also like worked with different people. So using communicating powerfully showed his ability of, you know, talking to people and other things like just giving advice and like having good people skills in general. I utilize my leadership skill well because I had to do many things in my office, like a lot of things at certain times, and then I had to do them quickly because I had to get as much as I could done in a single day. And so yeah, so I utilize my leadership skills, and I also had like set goals for that day. And so why I learned about myself is I really don't mind working in business professions. It's actually pretty interesting, and I really liked working here. I also learned that I needed to be at work on time, and that one of the challenges I faced was transportation, because I really didn't have any in the beginning. My sister like took me 3 times, but then she got a job, and so I had to find like other people that could take me, and that was so thankful I could be here on time. And I also learned many different things, like how to say about, how to make my way work for me, and how, like, just about people skills in general, and how businesses work. Where I learned about this profession is that it's good to get help from financial advisors, because they are really helpful people, and they give you a lot of advice on what you should do. I also learned how they run businesses, and what they do to help their clients to understand that. I also learned about how financial planners get their jobs and how they help other people, and about the different criteria they have to meet in order to be hired. And what I learned about the world of work is it taught me that I have to grow at work. And that means that I have to not just be miserable at my workplace, because then there'd be no point to be at work. So I have to enjoy the best of my work and also do something that I want to do, because then I'd just be miserable all day. And I also learned to make money work for me, so like having more money come in than expenses, because then my network would be more. So like not being in debt a lot, that would help me. And what I learned about professionalism is that I have to take responsibility at work, so if anything happens, I'm responsible for it. And there's like not gonna be someone say, oh, it's okay, because you know, as an adult, you have to take certain responsibilities. And also, they had to do what you want to do, because if you just do something because you think it's gonna pay you a lot, does it really matter? Because if you're not happy there, you know, it's not really worth it. And also, you know, just to be happy at work, because if you're not, then it's gonna be pretty bad. What I learned about finding a job, the first thing I had to do was create a cover letter and a resume. And then also learned